Hey folks, this is Best in Slot. Welcome to our Mod of the Week Spotlight series for Jurassic World Evolution 2. Last week we did an individual video on the fantastic Paleozoic Swamp Decoration Pack by Luca. We're going to check out another incredible decoration pack by Luca in just a minute, as well as a bunch of new species and some very cool Jurassic World Evolution 1 old school cosmetics, which I'm really excited about. But before all of that, quick disclaimer: as per usual, mods can cause problems with your save files, especially when the game updates. The game may never update ever again, we'll have to wait and see, but if it does cause problems with your game, if you install something incorrectly, yada yada yada, not my fault, not the mod maker's fault, not Frontier's fault. That's the important bit. Luca has also just brought out a new decoration pack. You can just see it over there in the distance. A new decoration pack that might be a little bit more malleable and usable for a wide variety of creatures. This is the Mesh Fences decoration pack, and it adds 10 new mesh fences, walls, roofs, and even staff entrances, as you can see. And in here I've built, so it's like a birdcage kind of thing. You'd see it at a zoo, and in here I've built like a little Microceratus habitat. They're quite hard to see because they're so small. They're quite hard to see through the mesh, but we should be able to actually head inside. And I'll show you how this is all built in just a second. But if you come over here, we've got this staff gate section. Guests can't walk through this, but in first person mode, I can. Obviously, it's not animated. We're not living in that world, but very cool. And inside, you know, I think it looks fantastic. I think it's really cool stuff. And again, more decorations along with these. I mean, Luca's really brought their A-game in the last couple of weeks. Stuff that really lets you turn your park into much more what a modern zoo would look like. And I think that's kind of something the game needs. I may have chosen slightly too large egg sizes. They've come out of the eggs fully sized. So I'm going to show you how this works. We're also just going to throw in a slightly larger dinosaur just to showcase this a little bit better. Mitosaur is probably a little bit too big, but I've been a little rude to it over the years. So I figure, there you go. I think that's really, really, really cool stuff. So when you download this mod, you just install it the regular way. And we're going to come down to our fourth tab here. And if you scroll down towards the bottom, you'll see you've got these new items over here. You get a ceiling, a raised one, like this is one I used over here. You can also do this with round roofs instead. You've got a flat square, you've got a flat smaller square, you've got the staff entrance double gate thing over there, and you've got a regular staff gate that looks more like that without the sort of Jurassic Park style thingamajiggy. A gigantic mesh wall here for the round roof. I didn't really understand how this one worked, if I was totally honest. An anti-climb wall, so you can see it's got like the bits jutting out at the top there that stops animals. You put that on the inside, so that would face in towards your animals like that. Your animal would be on this side, and that stops your animal climbing up. Again, another thing we see in zoos all the time. I'm just going to give you some advice. Make sure you flatten the area first. You're probably going to want Kai's Wii Toolbox installed. It'll make your life a lot easier. And also, when you're lining these up, you want to line them up not... So my inclination from Planet Zoo is to do that, you know, kind of like have it inside it in a way. You know, who doesn't... No, I'm not making that joke. But if you just line it up like that, it'll fit the roof better. You want it to conjoin but not be inside each other, basically. And yeah, a little smaller than the Mitosaur, but I say that you could make this exhibit as big as you wanted. Maybe stick a couple of these roofs together. You could have a gigantic wireframe habitat, so it's completely customizable for whatever animal you want. And yeah, I mean, that just looking at that makes me happy. So big shout out to Luca. Of course, this and all the other mods will be linked down below, but I highly recommend, if you're playing with mods, you download both of these decoration packs, because it gives you so much zoo-like customizability. And yeah, that's cool stuff. Right, let's check out some brand new species. Here we go. Well, this beautiful creature is Hippocrosaurus by Masterdoot, commissioned by Girouette. This is a hadrosaurid from the late Cretaceous of the US and Canada. Now, it's unique because of mainly its high neural spines, as you can see. There's another species which I think I would suggest has even higher neural spines than this, and it gives it this kind of humpback sail kind of look going down. Its back gives it a lot of height as a dinosaur. Now, there are a huge number of Hippocrosaurus fossils found in Montana particularly, supposedly killed by volcanic ashfall, suffocating them, and the gases from that ashfall. Now, whilst researching this dinosaur, I learned two new words here during this segment, so hopefully we can learn together. So the first one, Autocathonus. I'm going to say Cathonaus. I don't know, actually. Autocathonus. I'm going to go nuts. Autocathonus, which in geology in particular means formed in its present position. Okay? So for these guys, for these Hippocrosaurus, what that means is where they were found, where the fossils were found, is where they died. They weren't moved post-mortem by the tides, by rivers, by rockfall or whatever. We found them in their death position, essentially. It's like Pompeii, basically. This group of Hippocrosaurus had a huge variety. We have like really good fossils for Hippocrosaurus. Had a huge variety of ages, spanning from newborns, juveniles, all the way up to fully mature adults. And that makes this group a bioconosis. And that means a living community. All living in one place, all living in one time, and then rendered in the fossils. So by looking at the fossils of Hippocrosaurus, we can see this bioconosis come to life, basically. We can see their living community. Does that make sense? Anyways, this is a really beautiful mod by Master Doom, as it always is. This one in particular, actually, the green, I think is my favourite. Rendered really well, feels very different than the other hadrosaurids in the game. As you can tell, it's a Lambeosaurine by the head crest shape and stuff like that. I really like the thickness on the neck. We've got the wrinkles in there, the sort of the fat and muscle folding in and making that lovely body shape. Big sharp crest there as well. Beautiful patterns, really realistic looking, but tons of variety. Really like this. I mean, some of them go a little bit bonkers, which is cool. You need a little bonkers in your life. Rendered, rigged, modeled beautifully. Hippocrosaurus by Master Doom always brings the right game. Really, really like this one, actually. It's nice to see more hadrosaurs as well, because I feel they get a little bit neglected. And our next new species is Dravidosaurus by Trippy28, a late Cretaceous, maybe probably a Stegosaurian. It was discovered in India in the 1970s, and whilst there's a decent number of various fossils, I really like this skin, decent number of various fossils, they're in terrible quality, so it's made classification really difficult. With one researcher, I think in the 90s, if I remember, suggesting it's not even a stegosaur, they suggested it's a plesiosaur. Now, admittedly, that has been somewhat widely derided since then, with most people agreeing it's an Ornithischian, if not a stegosaurian. Now, this is quite important, though, to figure this out, because whilst it's still very much being worked on, you know, fossils are being analysed right now as we speak, could be at this very moment in time. If this is a stegosaurian, it will be the latest stegosaurian ever discovered from the late Cretaceous. We've had no stegosaurs from the late Cretaceous before, so Dravidosaurus would be the latest stegosaur ever found. By tens of millions of years, it would have outlived other stegosaurs, so if that's true, it could call into question all of our knowledge on stegosaur evolution and lifespan or time span that they existed, sort of thing. It either suggests that our knowledge of stegosaurs is quite limited and there's many more out there we don't know about, or it would suggest that they've survived in India much longer than anywhere else. They've gone extinct all around the world, but the stegosaurs in India have managed to survive tens of millions of years later than everyone else. Either way, very interesting stuff. And was actually a new dinosaur for me. I don't think I'd been aware of Dravidosaurus before today, so really cool to see that come to life. I love when mod makers tackle some slightly more obscure species. Where's my favourite one gone? We're over here. I really like this one. I think it really suits this sort of light brown naturalistic colouring. Love the stripes as we fade down from the plates onto the spikes there along the back. We don't have too much material on Dravidosaurus, so they can kind of you can kind of interpret it however you want. We've got some Kentrosaurian sort of details going on here. But yeah, the texture and the sort of colourway, all these milieus of browns and blacks and greens and greys all melding together. It's really cute, looks really good, rendered really nicely. Just another fantastic Stegosaurian, another very cool mod by Trippy. So very, very weird. This is Moss Chops. Moss Chops by Hokal1215, a therapsid from the Permian of South Africa. Bizarre looking creatures, to say the least, you know. It's very, very weird. And this is what it looked like. It genuinely did look like this. This is absolutely bizarre. 9 feet long, up to 722 pounds in maximum mass. They likely lived much like a modern hippopotamus would. Heavily built plant eaters that spent a lot of time grazing and spent a lot of time chilling in the water. Now their skulls, as you can see, are, well, I mean their head shape would suggest they've got a very thick skull. Moss Chops had a very thick skull, and the suggestion is they maybe did some headbutting as kind of like a dominance display sort of thing. Now again, more new things I learned today. There was a 2017 study that did something called synchrotron scanning. Now, it's a level of physics I'm not going to pretend to understand, but it's basically you use a particle accelerator and you use that to generate what's called synchrotron light, and that lets you observe matter in incredible levels of detail. I don't know what's going on with this one. It just doesn't want to leave the hatchery. It's very nervous. You know, it's like when a cat or a dog gets to a new home and they're a little hesitant initially. That Moss Chops is not vibing with it quite yet. Anyways, it generates synchrotron light, lets you observe this matter on incredible levels of detail, sub-nanometer levels of detail. It's good for, you know, people use it in medicine and stuff like that sometimes. Anyway, this scanning revealed biological adaptations in the skull of Moss Chops, which would suggest it was well-suited to combat, i.e. supporting the headbutting theory that they bash each other in the skull in order to assert dominance and vie for mates. And stuff like that. There's a really weird shadow effect going on here that I can't quite explain. Anyways, this is Moss Chops by Hokal1215. Very, very strange. I don't know what else to say about it. The model is really cool. It's got a really nice variety of bizarre skins that all look very strange. You know, you can really pick and choose whichever colours you want to use for this thing. It's got a slightly weird texture. I think the scaling on the head in particular is maybe a little bit too small. It needs some smoother bits to round it out. But I think, and the eyes are terrifying, which I think is probably on purpose. But I think the body shape in particular, anything up to like the top of the neck, is really, really well rendered. Looks really cool. Really, really strange creature. And I'm going to need to get out of the way for our next view. Oh, there you go. Join your friends. Okay, this is a sauropod, so I'm not going to bother. I'm not going to wait because we know it'll take a gajillion years. This is Sauroposeidon by Jojo Chess. With several S's. I don't think we've ever covered a JoJo Chess mod before. I think they're new. I think this is only their second mod. I'm not sure what the first one was. But the Sauroposeidon is pretty cool. Now, this is a gigantic sauropod from the early... I love that noise. A gigantic sauropod from the early Cretaceous of the United States. The name means, and it's one of the coolest names, it means Lizard Earthquake God, which is baller stuff. Now, as you can see, they've rendered it as though it's a brachiosaur. You can kind of tell by the head shape in particular and the neck position and stuff like that. And I'd say the general morphology and the skull shape in particular is very brachiosaur. If Sauroposeidon is related, or is a brachiosaur, which is the current prominent theory, then this thing was truly gigantic, up to 60 feet tall, 112 feet long, one of the longest and heaviest, potentially one of the tallest, if not the tallest dinosaur to ever exist. It's also the state dinosaur of Texas, which is fun. Everything's bigger in Texas, as they say. Now, there is still a debate as to whether it is a brachiosaur. Some people suggest it could be a titanosaur, which would, of course, change some of those estimations. But either way, it's a gigantic, gigantic sauropod. And this is, yeah, it's a really nice mod. Actually, I really like the skull shape, which feels like a brachiosaur, but demonstrably different from the brachiosaurus we have in the game. Really interesting, this kind of large... sort of almost, what's the animal I'm thinking of in my head? Leopard? kind of leopard spotting kind of... Well, I can't remember what leopards were. There's kind of leopard spotting going down the neck there. Some striping there along the legs. Patterns you don't really see rendered in sauropods very often. I think it's... Yeah, pretty beautiful sauropod. Really nice to have more sauropods again. Like Hadrosaurus is one of those things I feel... I talk really fast, don't I, sometimes? Like Hadrosaurus, I feel it's one of those things we don't get that often. But, yeah, looks beautiful. And very excited to see more from JoJo Chess. Just so I can say JoJo Chess, if nothing else. Okay, one more mod to show you, but this is a pack. This is the Jurassic World Evolution Legacy Pack by Game Videos for Life. And this brings back some fan favorite cosmetics from Jurassic World Evolution 1 as cosmetics in Evolution 2. So it doesn't replace anything. It's just a new cosmetic, a new skin for these four dinosaurs. I'm going to show you all of them because they've also brought back what was my personal favorite skin in all of Evolution 1, or at least top five. So yeah, let's get started. So Albertosaurus, it's funny, this skin is much nicer, I think, than the Evolution 2 skin system is better. It really is. But there are a few skins from Evolution 1 that I think are much more interesting. Because if we look at this Albertosaurus here, I think this is a really nice skin. This is the jungle one. So there's jungle, steppe, and tundra. What a beauty. Now, we've got our Albertosaurus here. If we grab another Albertosaurus... Now, admittedly, this is not the most exciting Evolution 2 skin, but it is a patterned skin. And as you can see, it's got that kind of Evolution 2 problem in that they've had to come up with skins for 100 plus creatures and loads that had already existed, 70 or so that existed in Evolution 1. So it just kind of has these boring splotches. Yeah, I've been complaining about this a little bit lately, more and more, the frontier splotches, and the Albertosaurus is unfortunately covered in them. And I think you can see the pattern on the left... A lot less customizable. It always looks like this just in different colors, but it's a much cooler pattern than the one on the right. It's much more interesting. We've got the color there over the crest. We've got all these interesting marks under the eyes. We've got this kind of gradient effect going down from the top to the bottom in the way that it kind of splits off in these sort of scale leopard spot against kind of shapes. It's a much cooler looking dinosaur than the Evolution 2 variant. Let's check out the others. So this is the coastal Ceratosaurus skin. Again, very evocative with that red head shape really standing in contrast to the colour of the body, which is kind of a sort of purplish sort of colour. It's more purple than I remember it being, but really sharp contrast with the red head there. Dead. This is the only skin that the Ceratosaurus got. But again, it was one of the more popular ones. It was one of the more famous ones for the first game. Absolutely beautiful. So the Stegosaurus has also had the same treatment. We've got the woodland, steppe, and rainforest skins. I don't like the rainforest one, but this one, huh, a thing of sheer beauty. Beautifully textured and coloured body, just kind of fading from that woodland green down to the sort of the yellows and then the white underbelly. And it's that really strong tiger striping on the plates that really brings this one to life. A really, really beautiful dinosaur. Let's max out one. There you go. It's not too different. It's more in the colours on this one, I would say, more than anything else, in terms of the differences between the two. So that's the Evolution 2, that's the Evolution 1. The striping's maybe a bit stronger, but I'd say they're largely pretty similar. Pattern-wise, there wasn't too much difference between the two games. Now, next one, my second favourite skin, as far as I remember, in Evolution 1. Let's check it out. A thing of sheer beauty. I believe this is Coastal. Yes, this was one of my all-time favorite skins in Evolution 1. This, I don't use Styracosaurus in Evolution 2, and I loved it in Evolution 1. And I loved it mainly because of this Coastal skin. There's something about this skin on the Styraco that just makes it look awesome. The white coloration there, almost skull-like on the, skull and across the frill, going along the back there and then dropping into that sort of darker grey colour. It looks fantastic. It's got shades of the Dinosaur Revolution Tyrannosaurus Rex, which is always cool. It's just not the same. I mean, I don't dislike this Styraco. I think the addition of the circles there on the frill is probably a really good thing. And this one does have a nice pattern anyway, this kind of fading down, dropping, and then this sort of splatter pattern down there at the bottom. The Evolution 2 Styraco is quite nice. It's just I had a deep, deep love for the Evolution 1 Coastal skin. And now you get both. The only reason it gets second rather than first is because there was an Indominus Rex skin that was like black and purple. It had like galaxy coloration to it, and that was my all-time favorite skin in Evolution 1. It's a big shame we don't have it in Evolution 2. But very cool to have these fan favorites back. So thank you very much for joining me. If you did enjoy the video, please throw me a like down below, a comment, let me know which of these mods you'd potentially use, which you're most excited by, what's your favorite of the skins in a new pack. If you were going to make a Wave 2, which I think is the plan for this Evolution Legacy pack, what skins from Evolution 1 and what dinosaurs would you include? Let me know down below. Throw a subscribe if you're new to the channel. Yada, yada, yada. Remember to go give the mod makers all the love in the world. They super deserve it, as per usual. And hope you all have a lovely week. Thank you for joining me. Cheers, much love as always. Bye-bye.